How's it going, everyone? Chris here, and welcome back to another Super Smash Bros. Ultimate DLC Leak discussion video. In today's video, we are actually going to be taking a look at a very interesting new leak because apparently somebody hacked and data mined their Nintendo Switch and found a bunch of new information on games as well as Super Smash Bros. Ultimate Challenger Packs. However, guys, as always, and I cannot stress this enough, just because this apparently comes from a hacked Nintendo Switch, that does not mean that this is going to end up being 100% real, so make sure you guys take this with a grain of salt and realize that I'm talking about this just for fun. Unfortunately, guys, I do not have a link to the original post, as everything the leaker provided me is just screenshots, so everything that you guys are going to need to see is going to be up on screen. And now, guys, with all of that out of the way, I have to tell you guys where this leak came from. So guys, this leak was sent in to me by one of my subscribers on my Discord server, so if you guys haven't already joined up, you can find a link to my Discord as well as links to all of my other social media presences such as my Twitter, Twitch, and Patreon in the description bar down below as well as the pinned comment. Now guys, there is something I need to make very clear. I absolutely do not condone hacking your Nintendo Switch. It is wrong, it is illegal, and it can get you guys in a ton of trouble. I do not know if this image is real, so that's why we're going to be talking about it today, because I want to see if we can either prove or debunk it. But do not, and I repeat, do not hack your Nintendo Switch. It's not worth it, and it just makes Nintendo lose money and not want to develop games as frequently. So guys, don't do this, please. And now guys, with that out of the way, let's go ahead and take a look at what it has to say. So guys, like I said, this image apparently comes from a hacked slash data mined Nintendo Switch, so let's go ahead and take a look at it. So as you guys can see on screen right now, we see a list of games, so let's start at the top. So up top we have Bayonetta 2, followed by FIFA 20, Dragon Quest XI S, EA Sports FIFA 20, Fire Emblem Three Houses, Monopoly, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, New Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe, Pokemon Let's Go Eevee, for some reason that's there twice, and then we get to the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate stuff. So as we can see, we have Super Smash Bros. Ultimate Challenger Pack 2, another Challenger Pack 2, a third Challenger Pack 2, and then a fourth Challenger Pack 2, followed by Challenger Pack 3, another Challenger Pack 3, Challenger Pack 4, and Challenger Pack 5. After that, we see Super Smash Bros. Ultimate Spirit Board Challenge 1. So guys, one of the most interesting parts about this leak is that it does not list any character names at all. As you can clearly see, all it says is Challenger Pack 2, 3, 4, and 5, and none of the names are available. Now, I did get some information from the person who sent me this, who had a conversation with the person who originally data mined all this information, so let's go ahead and see what they have to say. So at the top, guys, I did redact all of their names because they asked me to, so let's go ahead and take a look at what they have to say. So he says, that's the file with all DLC and updates, to which my source responds, too bad I can't just use my Smash All, and then he says, yes, all, like, all. Will you just tell me if I have access to blank? We're not supposed to have. I can't answer that. Well, why is that? Because rule 2 in the server, well, tell me in the DMs. Even then, I just don't want to waste my time. You can't even tell me if it's a waste of time. To which the original guy says, this is not a waste of time. So if we take all this information at face value, we have someone who apparently did actually go ahead and do this and has this information now, which is pretty interesting. Now, one of the things I feel as though I should mention is that the Nintendo Switch has a ton of people who hack it and pirate games all the time. So honestly, I'm surprised I haven't seen more of these before. I mean, there are people that like download like Pokemon games from like the Game Boy on the Nintendo Switch. There's videos of it all over YouTube, and like I said, although I do not recommend hacking your Nintendo Switch at all, you could still see what other people have done if you just search it up. I mean, it's absolutely crazy some of the stuff that these people have done. So honestly, this isn't that surprising. I'm sure that a lot of this information actually is in the Nintendo Switch, but I kind of wonder, like, why would all of this information already be here? Now, obviously, we have seen data mine leaks happen all of the time. I don't know how many of you guys remember this, or how many of you guys were even Smash fans, like during the Smash for Wii U and 3DS days, But there was actually a leak of Ryu where somebody was playing as a character that wasn't even announced yet because they somehow managed to manipulate the code to put Ryu over Mario. So I kind of feel as though Nintendo of Sakurai have wisened up to this a little bit. Now, these could definitely just be placeholders. I'm not going to say that these are like absolutely definitive characters because it is really early. However, it's still really interesting that all this stuff is on here. Now, in terms of why it says like Challenger Pack 2 multiple times, I really have no idea. If any of you guys know anything about like coding or why all this information would be in this code, please let me know. Now, I know that there are some skeptics out there that are probably going to say this is fake. And guys, like I said, it could possibly be. However, this does look like it's coming from a Nintendo Switch. If you guys look at the bottom left corner and up the side, you can clearly see that that is a Nintendo Switch screen that somebody is currently looking at. So I'm pretty confident that at the very least, this is a hacked Nintendo Switch. Now, one of the other things I feel as though we need to address is this could possibly be from the first Fighter's Pass. I mean, obviously, Challenger Pack 2 could be the hero, Challenger Pack 3 could be Banjo-Kazooie, and maybe that's why we have all of these different, like, for 2, we have 4 different variations of 2, and for 3, we have 2 different variations, because these characters are already playable in Smash, while Challenger Pack 4, Terry Bogard, is not quite yet, and Challenger Pack 5, we have no idea who it is. However, like I said, if there is information in this, that means that people are able to data mine and go through it, so maybe they are starting to find code for Terry Bogard, or maybe even the fifth DLC fighter. It is entirely possible, as crazy as it sounds. So then, I actually did go back, and I got even more information from the person who originally sent me this. So he says, installing Smash and the DLC pack, because I asked, what exactly is this? He says, I have 2 Switches. He cannot tell me if or what works, but I am hyped. I want to know Character 5, but I don't. It has to be huge. Switch CFF, man. Having them does nothing unless you data mine that. The update adds the character, not the DLC pack. So like I said, guys, it looks like there may already be information in here regarding characters. However, we can't actually get to them. Now, I don't know how many of you guys remember this, but back after we knew that Joker was coming to Smash Ultimate, and after Joker was officially released in April, there were a group of people who actually hacked the Nintendo Switch and were able to find a way to put all of the character properties of the hero onto another character. We saw a character, I believe it was Link, running around with the speed of Hero, but he couldn't use any of his movesets. All we got to see was his running and jumping and stuff like that, so we could test like how fast he can run and how high he could jump. So all of this stuff is entirely possible, guys. Now, I'm curious to see if maybe something else like that comes out very soon. I mean, if there actually is already even a little bit of code in that Challenger Pack 5 slot, it's entirely possible that someone could go through it right now and move all of the assets over from that character onto a character that's already in Smash. I mean, heck, guys, it's entirely possible that pretty soon we could actually be seeing how high Terry Bogard can jump, how fast he can run, how quickly he falls, and someone will probably just place all of his assets over a character like Ken or Ryu, because obviously that would make sense. Now, once again, guys, I absolutely do not condone you doing this, so please don't go ahead and try to do this, but I have a feeling it's going to pop up eventually. Now, the last thing that I want to go ahead and say is that although they do have access to a bunch of different games like Bayonetta 2, Let's Go Eevee, New Super Mario Bros. U Deluxe, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, that means that this is probably all current information, so all of this information is in the code right now. Which means that these challenger packs are probably referring to the characters that are appearing on this Fighter's Pass and not the next Fighter's Pass. However, I could be wrong. It is entirely possible it is referring to the next one. And because I don't know that much about this stuff, maybe I'm just not seeing what you guys are seeing, so let me know in the comments. However, guys, with all of that being said, do I believe that this leak is real? Honestly, guys, I'm not 100% sure. I've never tried to hack my Nintendo Switch. I really don't know anything about it at all. So if you guys have any idea if this leak is real, please let me know in the comment section down below. Once again, final time, do not hack your Nintendo Switch. And with that being said, though, guys, let me know your thoughts about this leak in the comments. Let me know if you're happy with it. Let me know if you want to see more of these, like, if you want to get all this information beforehand, or if you feel like we should just wait. So thank you guys all so much for watching. Make sure to subscribe, share, and like, and I will see you guys next time. Take care.